under sections 125 to 128 of Criminal Procedure Code 1973, an order of maintenance can therefore be passed in favor of a wife if the wife is unable to maintain herself, the husband has sufficient means, the husband has neglected or refused to maintain her, the wife had not refused to live with the husband except for sufficient cause, the husband having contracted a second marriage or keeping a mistress and the wife refusing to live with him, the wife not living in adultery, the husband and wife not living separately by mutual consent, the wife has not remarried after the dissolution of marriage. Under Islamic law, it may be noted again, a wife is entitled to maintenance irrespective of her financial position. A Muslim who has sufficient means of her own to support herself can therefore not claim maintenance under the provisions of the new code, but she can agitate her claim under Muslim law in a civil court. Under the code, even a divorced woman is entitled to claim maintenance from her husband. A plain reading of Clause B, subsection 3 of section 127 of Criminal Procedure Code shows that if the husband has paid off either before or after the date of order under section 125, the sum which is already payable by the husband to the wife under any customary or personal law of the parties, the magistrate, if satisfied about it, shall cancel the order passed by him. However, this provision has been subject of conflicting interpretations. The Supreme Court for the first time was faced with the question of the construction of Clause B, subsection 3 of section 127 in Bai Tahira v. Ali Hussain. In this case, the husband, Ali Hussain, divorced his wife in 1962. A compromise was made in respect of properties and the amount payable to her by way of mehr and iddat money. A clause in the compromise deed provided, I quote, "The plaintiff declares that she has now no claim or right whatever against the defendant or against the estate or properties of the defendant," unquote. But after coming into force of the code 1973, she claimed maintenance under section 125. Justice Krishna Iyer made certain observations. Payment of mehr money as customary discharge is within the cognizance of provision of clause B, subsection 3 of section 127. The key thought is adequacy of payment, which will take reasonable care of her maintenance. The payment of illusory amounts by way of customary or personal law requirement will be considered in the reduction of maintenance rate, but cannot annihilate that rule unless it is reasonable substitute. The whole scheme of section 127 is manifestly to recognize the substitute maintenance arrangement by lump sum payment organized by the custom of the community or the personal law of the parties. There must be a relation between the sum to be so paid and its potential as provision for maintenance. To interpret otherwise is to stultify the project. The proposition, therefore, is that no husband can claim under section 125 towards a divorced wife except on proof of payment of a sum stipulated by customary or personal law whose quantum is more or less sufficient to do duty for maintenance allowance.